Welcome to another episode of Soto Desperado Plays Conan Exiles. Well, no, actually, it's Conan Exiles Savage Wilds map. Anyway, this is not going to go into the game series that I'm trying to record. Okay, so the reason for this video is, besides the fact that I'm trying to grind a little bit here, is, well, if you look at the date of the video, this is some, lots of things are going on. If you watch online trends, you know, normally I don't get involved anymore. I don't really do anything anymore. I used to have an opinion. I used to be opinionated because of my experience. Okay? And I just don't have it in me to have one much. But I've been watching. And after so many years, you watch and you start to make connections. And after you make those connections, you realize, holy shit, stuff's really going down. Now, the purpose of the video is just to go over some of my thoughts on current events, as in how things are being structured out there, how you know, the stuff that's happening, the trending videos that we see of people trying to make a fast buck on the internet by, you know, throwing together little videos and shit like that. Which is fine, you know, you gotta make your scratch somehow. You know, you gotta scratch a living out of this world somehow. But, you know, ultimately, I kind of feel sorry for everybody, because think of it this way, and this is just my perspective. I'm not saying this is directly from the throne of God or anything like that. This is just my perspective on things, okay? You have people on there, this is trending, talking about how bad the economy is, how they have to have 2-3 jobs just to break even. They don't have the money for vacation. They can barely pay their bills. They're in debt up to their eyeballs after investing in a college education. I'm in that position, so I empathize. I honestly, truly do empathize with people who went for a formal education, paid thousands of dollars, and walked away with a bunch of promises that didn't add up to anything. You know, in the old days, we called that fraud. You know, oops. So nowadays, it's just everyday life. Things are getting to the point where, you know, what happened is this. This is the way I see it. I hope you guys aren't hard on me for this, okay? This is a very worldly opinion. I'm not putting any spiritual stuff in there yet. This is the worldly opinion. People are funny, okay? Like me, I play my video games and I get my cheap jollies, right? Other people, they skimmity scam you on TikTok or whatever. And, you know, they make thousands of dollars. It just depends. But this is people reacting to things. They're reacting to a certain state. Oh, look, this is my structure there. And what they're trying to do is they're trying to justify their actions. And they're trying to adapt to a situation that is normally outside the usual norm or boundaries. Now, the value of a dollar's gone down. You know, you don't get as much as you used to. So people are trying to compensate by justifying opening a business, cycling through different methodologies and making money online. They're trying to adapt financially to something that has been in the works since I can remember. even when I was a young Christian, they told us about prophecy and the end of the world. Where's that tiger? It's supposed to be up here. I heard the tiger. I think I did. Anyway, it's supposed to be a tiger up here. Okay, maybe there's not one anymore. I did build a base underneath it, so it probably disappeared. Anyway, the point is that people will justify whatever convenient lie suits them so that they can get what they want. Okay? It's a cold truth of the world. I justified my position as a young saint and the authority of the Most High God because, well, you know, I really loved people at the time. Now I don't anymore. Now I can care less because my heart's broken. My soul's broken. My love is dead. My soul has become dead. It's rotten away. It's faded away. And I've become just a husk of a person. I used to have 3-4 times the ability to think and perform than I do now. Nowadays I'm on medication. And that sure as hell doesn't help me. Not the way I would like it to, anyway. But you see what I'm saying? People justify what they do, their actions. And some of these justifications are just fraud. You know, it's just wrong what they do in some cases. But what you learn when you look at history and you look at some of the things you'll see in movies and stuff is people are taught that if it's cool, it's justifiable. If it's in, you know, it's justifiable. And that isn't always the case. Gotcha. Okay. And the thing is, this world and these people, you guys, you're doing what you have to do to survive. You're in survival mode right now, and you're trying to adapt. Because the rules of nature is you adapt or you perish, right? This deer failed to adapt, so I'm going to skin his ass. There you go. Now, if the deer was greater than me, he'd be kicking my ass. Going through my armor, tearing me to shreds. But it's not his nature to do that. It's not the deer's nature to do that. So if it adapts, it has to adapt a different way, okay? It has to run away from me. And the way they programmed it in this game, it obviously does not run very far at all. It just doesn't run. So that's why it's dead. And it becomes my hide. So I can do stuff with it. Okay, I just want to make sure nothing else up here. I don't think there's anything else here. Okay, oh, here's some more guys. So that's what's really going on in the world right now. People are becoming desperate because of the value of a dollar going down. Your spending power has gone down. Your bills have stayed in place. Your debts are still in place. You're not getting any raises. They're letting go of people left and right, right? So they're setting us up for a fall. Everybody, we're going to go down one way or another. And so what's happening, and this is happening spiritually, financially, and in some cases physically. Oops. Let me get this guy. Got you. So they're adapting in various ways, and they're just looking for whatever works, whatever works, whatever works. If I have to sell you a turd with a shine on it and call it a gold bullion, that's what I have to do. I have no choice. You know? I have to do that. I have to do it. You know? And if I have to, you know, put TikTok videos out or sell you some cheap Chinese garbage or, you know what I mean? Whatever bullshit I have to sell you to get paid is justifiable given my circumstances. But the problem is everybody's going through those circumstances. And everybody's justifying that at the same time. That's a trend. It's like the rats know that the ship is sinking. So they're starting to climb up out of the bowels of the ship. And they're trying to go up on the ropes. And they're just trying to start to stay above water because they're realizing, you know, they used to be in the bowels of the ship where it was nice and dark and quiet and there was a little bit of food down there. They're realizing there's no more food and the ship is sinking. It's starting to fill with water. And so they're starting to try to struggle to survive by adapting to the circumstances. And you could only adapt so far to circumstances. Isn't that a beautiful map? Yeah, this map is so beautiful. I love the grass. But the point is that you can't let things get to you in the end. This whole thing, if you ever listen to the old time prophecies, Christian and otherwise, there's going to be great wars, rumors of wars and all this, but that's told from generation to generation just to keep everybody on edge. Nowadays, it's like this shit is starting to come to pass. It's starting to freak me out even, because even though I heard about it, it's not the same. It's not the same, because when you start seeing it happening, it's a different story. And people are following in to this script. You have to think of the Bible as a script, and they're following the script, and they're making this shit happen through finance, because they're in control of the world's finance. But they know how to push people's buttons, you know what I mean? They know how to do that. Like this guy. Like, I followed their methods, and boom, I know how to kill him. See? I know exactly how this creature acts, thinks, does. That's why I dodged the first one. It took me a while to figure it out, right? But eventually, I dodged it, you know? I dodged it. I learned how to dodge it. Hit, dodge, hit, dodge. And then I kill it. It's the same thing with humanity. They learned how to hit us and dodge, hit us and dodge. And that's what they're still doing. They're doing the same fucking thing. Again and again and again. And people, even if people are not in the know and they have no spiritual experience, they've never been demon-possessed. They've never been concentrated by the Holy Spirit. They've never been led of spirits. They never communicated with spirits. Even worldly, carnal people that have no real spiritual center other than the occasional prayer, which is fine, you know, or whatever your thing is, meditation. I don't care what you do. But the thing is, even regular, run-of-the-mill, carnal, down-to-earth, worldly people that just, they're about the facts and they're about physical reality more than anything, even they are starting to agree, oh shit, something's going on here. Even they are making videos on this shit going, oh wow, what the hell now? What is this? What's going on? How did this happen? And that's really what they're looking at. They're looking at the world that they had such faith in, an economy and a country, America, that they had such faith in, because it's supposed to be founded on basically righteous virtue is what they supposedly founded this country on. And they're seeing that it is disintegrating. It's been rotting, kind of like the depths of my soul, for quite some time. And it's sad. It's sad that it's come to that. It's come to a place where you just can't trust the media. You can't trust anything you purchase. You have to second guess everything. It's it was shady in the old days. Oh, look, that's somebody's base. Jeez. I'm not going to go all the way to hell up there. Screw that. I was going to go check it out and then just chill out here. So you get my point? People are adapting. They're trying to stay alive. Well, the thing is, guys, you know, 50 years ago, people were still trying to adapt and stay alive. They were just not under pressure. the value of a dollar was such that you can actually pay rent, pay your basic bills and some food and some basic maintenance, not fall too much in debt, and you'd make it out okay as long as you had consistent work, which is probably one of the greatest challenges. Oh, that's a path. The greatest challenges I've ever had is getting consistent work. I just couldn't get consistent work for years. I was in Laredo, I was in San Antonio. Everything's nepotism nowadays. I've been in my job for 6 years, over 6 years now, and it is the longest job I've ever had in my life. Before this job, the longest job I had was 2 years, I believe. Just two. All the other jobs were less than 2 years. You know, I couldn't get a career going to save my life. So that's why, just like so many other people, people are in debt. And the thing is, people will adapt and they will try to remain civilized, honest, and virtuous. But if you got to get that money to survive, most people will lie, cheat, steal, sell you out. You know, they'll sell you out to the system. They'll narc on you if they think you're doing something bad, or, you know. And this is what happened way back in the Nazi times. My grandmother, and I think I've said this before in some of my videos, she was alive, and I think I put in one of my videos, she was alive back then. She was from that era of Nazi Germany. And before she came to America, you know, she was trying to survive by scrubbing floors and stuff. When she had my father, she got pregnant by some GI. And he left her at the train station or something horrible like that. And, you know, she had him, and she was a hard worker. That woman, her name was Erica Rogan was her name. And I released that because she's already passed away, and I never had a lot of tight relations with her side of the family. But she was a very good woman. She was very frugal and realistic. And oh my God, no matter what you guys may think, that was the hardest working woman I've ever met in my life. Oh my God, I'm nothing. I'm like a slug compared to that woman. She had a huge thing in the backyard, a huge garden. They had long yards over there in Kansas. They're long. And she had it going all the way down, full of every kind of plant you can imagine. And she would maintain that and do work for the church and all kinds of stuff. And I'm like, wow. That woman was truly a hard worker, and she believed in hard work. She believed in it. She truly did. And a lot of people don't have those kind of work ethics nowadays. Nowadays, when you look at the trend, guys, this generation doesn't... There's a lot of thing going on. This Generation Z doesn't want to work. Well, the thing is, guys, who the fuck wants to work a job where you're not going to accomplish anything? If you put your work into it, your muscle, your time, your energy... Okay, you're going to want to get something, excuse me, you're going to want to get something out of it, right? Sorry about that. You're going to want to get something out of that labor. You know, I'm hitting this stupid rock, right? And I'm getting ore, I'm getting metal, I'm getting stone. You know, can you imagine if I hit this rock with this pickaxe and I don't get anything out of it? Maybe one stone? You know how pissed off I'd be if I just got one stone? You know what I would do if I just got one stone out of this rock and then I had to go get another? You know how much resources you need to make armor and weapons in this game? Thousands, man. Thousands of resources. If I can't even get a good amount of metal or something out of it that I can use, I'm not going to waste my time doing this shit. I'm not. I'm just going to go find another game to play. And that's what Generation Z has done. They realize that they're not getting it. If I hit this tree, I'm getting bark. I use bark, right? What if I hit this tree and it gives me like one bark? And I need like thousands of bark. It's just not worth it. And that's what's happening. Generation Z has to deal with the consequences, right? They have to deal with it. And they're realizing... one shot. That's good. They're realizing that it's just not worth it. You know? It is not worth bothering with this shit. So, think about it. Look at the trends out there. You guys have eyes in your head. Generation Z doesn't want to work. There's a push for van life. And they're glorifying van life like it's a wonderful thing. You know, you know, I have a backup plan to live out of my fucking vehicle if I have to. I have a Jackery. I think it's a Jackery 2000. I think it's a 1000 or 2000. It's a real big one that I bought before they put me in jail. I bought it because I thought I could use it to, you know, to survive. And I did. I lived in my car for about a week, week and a half without telling them because I didn't want them to put me back in the box again, even though I was out on bail. So, you know, I have backup plan. That's the only backup plan I have because my relatives are pretty much on their own. They don't care about me. My mom passed away a week after she bailed me, which I see as retaliation for helping me out. Because, you know, there's a real war behind the scenes going on. Regardless of what anybody thinks, it's real. So the thing is, what I've concluded is all these trends. Oh shit, I didn't know it was here. All these trends. Oh yeah, this is where I come to kill these guys, but they're kind of tough. I don't know if I want to mess with them right now. I don't want anything too complicated. So, Generation Z is waking up and saying, well, it's not worth applying my energy, my time, unless I can get something out of it enough to survive. And that just isn't the case anymore. Between the value of a dollar going down, opportunities going down, even though they're finding new opportunities, you know, through the internet, there's lots of opportunities on the internet, they still feel it's like, why am I giving my life to a company that doesn't take care of me? No, and they're right, because in the old days, before my generation, there were pensions, there was benefits that you didn't have to pay for. I have to pay for my benefits. It's not really a benefit. It's nothing more than them allowing you to get a discounted price on a group program for your insurances and stuff. That's all it is. You know, we never used to pay for that shit way back in the day. You know, it was rare that you had to pay for anything. Rare. And now became commonplace. Everybody, all the businesses got together and decided to do it. You know? And it's like, what the fuck? You know? What does this world come to? And the answer is, this world is just being used to squeeze people into a position. And they're going to continue to do that. Because they want people in a position of vulnerability. Going back to my grandmother, I asked her, and I think I put this out before. I said, what was Hitler's problem? Why did he do what he do? No, everybody hated him, and I don't understand why he did that. And I'll summarize this again. She basically said that when he started out, he was trying to get people off the streets, right? He was trying to get them off the streets. He was trying to get them jobs because just like now, they were in an economic depression. Germany was going through hell. And it was probably other places in the immediate area because it's all like one big area. But that's what happened. They were weak. They were vulnerable at the time. He swooped in and tried to play the hero. But in the end, ultimately, he went bad. He just went bad. Let me get down there. Make sure this guy dies. Okay. So the point is that he started out trying to get people off the streets, trying to get them jobs and shit. And in the end, he wound up becoming that dictator. And the thing is, Hitler was elected into power. So the way I see it is this. And this is this. I think this is a historical parallel. Okay? It's my opinion. I think that they're fattening us up with all this financial oppression, which is really what it is. Okay? And they're getting us into a position to where we will be so vulnerable. Anybody who is elected, who solves any of these problems that we have, will be welcomed into power. Now is when things are the most vulnerable. Honestly, think about it. If somebody came and solved the world's financial problems right now, wouldn't they be the next freaking president of the United States? Not Trump, but some other dude, even just some unknown dude that nobody knows. If he can solve all those problems, wouldn't that give him all the fucking power in the universe? Wouldn't that put him like in an Antichrist type of position? You see, that's why it was important to maintain a strong economy, so that we're not weak and that we are not easily conquered. You know, if we get conquered, we get conquered, right, guys? Any soldier knows that if you get conquered, you went down fighting, you did your best, then that's what you're supposed to do. Every soldier knows that. You go down fighting. And if we go down fighting. We will. But it didn't have to happen that way. Somehow, I didn't know this guy was there. So somehow I think that all this that you're going through, all this suffering and all these people struggling to survive like rats on a ship, trying to get into a place where, you know, try to get above water, not drown. I think what's going on is they predicted all this behavior. And they are doing it intentionally to go ahead and make sure that somebody comes to power that's on their side. In other words, if there was a time to push an Antichrist type of scenario, now's the time. Now's a good time, right now. I wouldn't say it's like the absolute best time, but I'd say it's really damn close, more than likely. So that's my opinion. I think you guys are going through all this shit simply because they set you up to do this. They set you up. I don't think it's anything anybody really did or didn't do right or what have you. I'm pretty sure that people by nature are kind of vulnerable because we're kind of naive. Like, I was very naive to think that I was going to purchase and earn a bachelor's degree and all of a sudden I was going to be accepted by people who are like twice as smart, three times as smart as I am, and four times as knowledgeable and experienced. I should have known better. I should have known better. Oh, I came back around. That's fine. Let's see. I wanted to go this direction here to try to get some black ice that makes some hardened steel. But the point is that I think that we are falling slowly but surely right into the hands of an Antichrist scenario, like in the scriptures that they've been talking about for years. Everybody knows about that shit. But the thing is, you don't really believe it till you start putting the pieces together. And you're like, oh shit. If this happens now, we are so fucked because we're vulnerable right now. We are truly vulnerable as a people. I wouldn't say a nation, because this is happening all over the world. People are dying out there. and everybody on the news and everything, they're covering some of it, but they're still, for the most part, in denial, in my opinion. I think they're just in denial. But anyway, the point is that I see it. I see what's going on here, and it's a vulnerability that we didn't have to inherit. You know, we didn't have to go through this. It just so happens that it's that time. I'm throwing in multiple things, but these are just worldly trends. And these worldly trends, they add up to, it's almost time for the bubble to burst. It's almost time for these dark entities, these dark Antichrist pieces of shit, to come out in the open. Now is the time for them to do that. Everybody's vulnerable. If we wait another 5 years, assuming things go as a trend, most of the population, that just softens them up even more. That's really all that does. It just makes the population, oh, look, there's that another house. It makes the population weaker and more vulnerable. More so. Let's see. I think I missed a turn. So I just wanted to make a quick video. It's only been half an hour. And just illustrate that, you know, she said he was like David Koresh. He started out trying to help everybody because they were in an economic slump. And then, you know, getting people off the street, giving them food, giving them work, trying to get them work. And then all of a sudden, he went crazy, she goes. And I go, what do you mean? She goes, he's like that guy. And I go, who? And she goes, that guy in Texas. And I'd like, David Koresh? Because that's the only, at that time, that was the crazy guy of the time, right? David Koresh. Well, David Koresh, guys, if you ever research him, he was boinking all of his parishioners' wives and shit, claiming to be the Messiah and trying to pass his seed along and shit. You know, trying to dominate or whatever you want to call it. Oh, I don't think I passed this correct. I was supposed to go straight that direction. Okay. That's why I missed it. I guess I can go around the seashore there and then take a right. But anyway, you see what I'm saying? The historical parallels are there. The similarities are there. The vulnerability and the state of human beings being, shall we say, prone to suggestion and prone to being open and vulnerable is there. It's right freaking there. It's possible. So if you were to ever compare this to anything, you'd have to say it is a kind of potential Antichrist scenario that before, in the 80s and the 90s, it was just being preached as a theory. And people would say, well, let's prophesy and all this. But you didn't really believe that shit. Nobody really believed it. They didn't see it. They'd look at the news and they would see people talking about things like that. But it wasn't, go this way. It wasn't anything critical. It wasn't crucial. It wasn't something that you would see every day. But in Germany, you were seeing it every day. You were seeing people out there in the streets with no food, no water. You know, it was like the Great Depression in America. It's the same shit. They're doing the same shit all over again. It's just a different age with a different generation. Oh, shit. Let me go do this. I won't die or anything, but you gotta watch those wrong turns, right? But the point is that I don't want anybody to think that what they're doing to survive is wrong anymore. We're at the point where you have to do what you have to do to survive. I didn't know there were people here.
Have you nothing better, Pop?
Okay. Hi.
Ugh.
He killed this guy real quick. And they gank you. Somebody thinks I'm stuck. I was talking to some other dude. Ah, I've never been here before. Oh, I never seen that. Crawl skin cavern. Man, I don't know what this is. What is that? Dude, who are you? Who the fuck are you? I don't give a shit. Neither does my sword, bitch. Anyway, I'm gonna skin your ass. It looks like I killed the wolf man and took his shit. So anyway, it looks like there's more of them down there. Can I swim over there? I guess I can go down on the shore. I just run. Looks like it's a little society of werewolves. Let's see if we can mark it on the map. Is it possible to mark it on the map? Hey, how you doing? Hey, how you doing? Oh, look, here's the entrance. No wonder I missed it. Hey, how's it going? I missed it. There's the entrance. Anyway, I'll just run for a bit. I was hoping I could mark it on the map so I can come back to it later when I have more time. But anyway, let's see. Am I going the right direction? Yeah, I am. Okay. So we're good so far. The point is that the trend, the historical precedence is the Great Depression and other kind of eras like that. It's during the times of weak economic stability that totalitarian governments take over. This is all very basic political stuff. You can look this up online and the trends are there. Now is when we're vulnerable. Now is when they try to convert us over to whatever the hell. Oh, I don't think I can survive this one. Oh, shit, I can't. Holy crap, I can't. Oh, I didn't know I could do that. I thought I was too weak for that. Those guys are pretty strong, traditionally. Those guys down there are like, fiery undead. Fuck it. Let's get out of here. Anyway. Yeah, I'm pretty sure. I'm going to take some healing. I have all these weak healing potions, and I also eat them up. I made like a bunch of them when I first started the game. I think that's where we're going to go. You know, this is just like, I'm playing my game. You know, I like to do this. But the thing is, I also survey these trends. The trends are going into people becoming more and more desperate and destitute. I have older people, aged people, elders, that are living out of a van off Social Security, and their Social Security is shit. It's nothing. And they're just, I could only spend like $2 on food today. I mean, holy shit. And that's how they're surviving. You imagine a human being living an active life, a bunch of horses, and in the end, they got nothing to show for it. They're living out of a vehicle, hoping to be able to afford the vehicle repairs. Because repairing a vehicle, guys, unless you know somebody, is expensive as hell. I mean, holy shit. You think you're living in a house when you drive that vehicle. Okay, so this is something, I don't know, hunting cabin. Black ice. Okay, this is where I have to go here. This is probably somebody's base. Yeah, that's somebody's base. I don't need to worry about that. So I'm looking for these big white animals so I can get some black eyes. And get rid of some of this food. I don't need all this damn food I carry. I like that one. I'm sure you guys get the point. There's a historical parallel here in this day and age. It's coming to pass. I'm seeing people get more and more desperate. When they get to a point of desperation, people will do anything. They'll sell each other out. They'll stab each other in the back. Over there in Nazi Germany, people were selling out the Jews, narking on the Jews. You see it in movies everywhere where people will just turn you in for a dollar. You know what I mean? So be aware that, like, people are trying to adapt. They're trying to adapt civilly now. So the rats are just starting to climb out from the bowels of the ship, trying to get above water because they know something's wrong. And they're just like starting to go out on the floor of the ship, you know, on the deck, I'm sorry, on the deck of the ship, on the top. And they're starting to come out. And they're starting to become more desperate. But as the sink ships, they'll start climbing ropes, going onto the mast, going up to the tippy top of the ship. And then after that, once everything goes down, they're going to do everything in their power to try to find like a barrel or something floating in the water that they can float on top of. And that's when you see people really, really taking advantage of each other and hurting each other. Silly, but true. People will do that. They'll sell each other out. And they'll use each other. And that's what you're seeing. See, business is really designed to exploit the human being. Business is not there to provide for the human being. Business is there to exploit a human being and all their worth. Okay? And that's what they do. And they're masters of it. They know how you think. They know how to manipulate your emotions. They know how you are going to behave, how you're going to react before you do it. They have models on this. They have schooling on this. If you go into management, you'll see that they cover lots of psychology in there. Oh. Ouch. These guys are pretty strong, but this is how I do it. As long as I keep hitting them, they're pretty much going to sit there and take it. Just like a good slave. They just sit there and take it until I kill them off. As long as I don't run out of stamina and I keep hitting them, they don't retaliate. See? Yeah. Now, this is not the black ice I wanted, but, you know, I'll take some obsidian because there's some obsidian weapons. And I'll take basic metal. So anyway, you see what I'm saying? It's there, and we're seeing it unfold. We're just seeing it and acknowledging it more. When the next generation, Gen Z, says we don't want to work anymore because there's no point to it, they are going to get more desperate. They are going to get more inventive on how to survive. And eventually, all these opportunities on the internet, with the way regulation goes, and they've been trying to control the internet for a very long time, that shit's going to go away. All that shit's going to go away. You know, they're going to take away those opportunities. They're going to find a way to justify sticking their nose in your business, just like any bureaucracy does, and take away those opportunities. You know? Let's see. Now, there's this creature over here that freaks me out. I don't know what it is, but it's pretty nasty looking. I don't know what this is. See, I shot it last time and it followed me. And it's like a wannabe Godzilla, maybe? I don't know. Huh? So what I want to do is mine everything around it. Since it, unless I aggro it, it won't do anything. Just go out this way. There's a way out over here. Now that creature has like three skulls on it. That's why I'm reluctant to get its attention. See, I can't kill it. I'm not strong enough to kill that thing. I know better than to take it on. And I should have known better than to take certain things on in my life when I was in youth, but that's a different story. Can I go back? See, if I'm directly behind it, I don't think it'll notice me. Let's see. See, I'm getting lots of gold and shit from here. Anyway, the trend is there. It looks like they are starting to squeeze. I call it the big squeeze, you know, like a financial or economic squeeze. And they're getting away with it because they know what they're doing. People are predictable. People are stupid. Alright? People are fucking stupid. Look at me. I'm risking all this for a few nuggets. But I know that if I die, I'm going to respawn in my base with all my inventory. With everything right here. You see? So it's worth it for me. Other people may not think so. See that little fucker there? That's a three skull monster there. It'll kill me easy if I get too close. You see? I'm getting there. I'm cleaning it out. And there's an exit over here on this side, or I can climb back up where I came from if I want. There we go. It's still not what I was looking for. Let me turn the light on. There we go. Use my best pick on here. Yeah, he's not going to attack. He can't aggro. He only has a certain range. Yeah, so I see the trend. Right now, they're trying to adapt. They're becoming desperate. They're trying to live together to try to save money. You see this. I listened to that guy, Jack Morgan. I see the trends in their titles. And the trend is we're trying to survive. We're trying to save money. We're trying to make our money last longer or stretch. See, before it was hard, you know, you had to save and stuff. Nowadays, you can't even have a fucking savings. I tell people, I said, you know, I work for a bank, and even I say, I don't see the point to a savings account. You can't take out more than 6 times without getting a fee, a $10 fee. If you transfer more than 6 times in a cycle, your interest rate is not high at all. You're not making any real money unless you have a lot of money in there, and most people don't. So you might as well get a secondary checking account, you know, and forego any interest because it's not even worth it. I think this is the way out. Yeah. Damn, it's hard to see. Really hard to see. Thought I had some more. Ah, here's some more. Yeah. There we go. Got some stuff. I got one recipe for this shit, for obsidian. I'm not even sure it's worth it, but we'll see. Thing is, I can't see long distance. It's black right now. Let me All right. Yeah. I think there's some more here. So, don't be surprised if people become more desperate. Right now, I work for that banking industry, and I can tell you right now that debit card fraud, I get it every single day. I guarantee you, I get somebody saying my card was compromised. So they're stealing cards left and right. And as far as identity theft, I get that maybe once a week. Somebody stole my information. They called me. They said they were a representative of the bank, and I gave them my information trying to authenticate after they called them. Oops. They called the customer or the client, and then all of a sudden they authenticate and lose that personal information. Which is sad. You should never do that. But a lot of the elderly people who don't really think in those terms are just being taken advantage of. I think those are some of the ones in you see that in the far distance there? Those are the ones that I want to kill. Because those guys will give me black eyes. See how they did it? What's this? What are you? What is that? What are you, a mutant rhino? Okay, well, I can use the thick hide. I could always use thick hide, rhino hide. There we go. Some weird mutant rhino. Looks to me like this is a minx. Okay. These guys give the hide too, I think. Anyway, I just thought I'd make a video and talk about it. I don't know what this is. Island lynx cub. Oh, it's a lynx cub. It's probably not even worth shit. I got a bear cub. I couldn't even raise the damn thing. So I have to wait till it's daytime so I can attack these other ones. So I'm going to go up here and just kind of chill. Oh, here's another one. It's hard to see this shit. I mean. Good thing is I'm getting lots of gold. Oh, look at that. Oh, there's more here. Shit, I didn't see this one. So, don't be surprised if people get more desperate, more creative. They're trying to remain civilized now because they can do that because they're finding side hustles and things like that. If the government ever decides to come down and make regulation that prevents you from having a side hustle or a side business, they can justify that a number of ways. When they started giving the stimulus out, especially to businesses, they gave out money to fraudulent businesses, millions of dollars to fraudulent businesses that the IRS would call around and say, oh, we're investigating these people because they didn't have a business after all, blah, blah, blah. And I'm like, really? Oh, look, the moon's still out. Damn, it takes forever for that thing to go down. Anyway, I'm just going to wait here. Don't be surprised if all this stuff that's going on comes together and turns into like an Antichrist type of scenario. That is a script that those spirits on the other side are following. They want that shit to happen. They want you to go crazy. They put a demon in me at some point. Nobody believes me, and I understand if you don't. But the truth is they did do that. And I was trying to be one of the good guys. And even though I'm not perfect, you know, I'm not a good man like I thought I was. You know, I made mistakes. I don't define myself by my mistakes. I define myself by how much I change and how much I learn from my mistakes. And I've learned quite a bit because I made some doozies. You know, I didn't kill anybody, but, you know, I've learned from what happened. They set me up to fail up to, I'm guessing, around 3 months prior to anything going on. So these plans were in effect 3 months before anything even happened. And even then, after it happened, they kept on my ass. So nowadays, every once in a while, I'll feel that dark energy when I think about this sort of thing, because it makes me irate. What happened makes me pissed off. I don't like being in a situation where I'm vulnerable or weak. I like being independent. I like having control. And they took away all that with the wave of a pen. Okay? They showed me that I don't mean shit. You're going to find out that once people start breaking the law, I mean, as it is, they stormed the Walmart and stole a bunch of shit. And half those kids weren't even covering their face. They were smiling because they knew they weren't going to be identified. Okay? These people are predictable. If you go over your history and you see all these key events where people rioted, marched, picketed, all these things, you're going to see corruption governing the entire world. It's bad. It's really bad. It's worse than I ever imagined it could be. Some of these people have demon spirits in them voluntarily. What I got was just to let you know how it works, just for FYI, you get seduced, you get manipulated and tricked into yielding. And once you yield, you open that door, that thing comes in and it gets to have fun with you. Oh shit. I heard that. So anyway. Oh, I don't know what that is, but it's close. Oh, that was loud too. Damn. So once you yield to it, it basically you're opening the door and it comes in. And like the scriptures say, it follows that programming that's in the scriptures. Okay? And it comes in, it sees that the house has been swept, and it just takes over and makes a mess of your life. And I lost all the money I had saved. I didn't have anything more than $4,000, but I lost that little bit. To me, that's a lot of money because I just have one little job. And it took years to save that up, and I'm still in debt up to my eyeballs. So for me, if I wanted to be a negative Nancy about it, I could say, well, I'm fucked. I should just give it up now. What the hell? Why am I bothering with this shit? Blah, blah, blah. Boo-hoo-hoo. You know what I mean? And you don't want to do that. Oh, look, there's crystal over there. Shit. That's probably crystal and black ice. I'm going to want some of that. Oh, there. That's another one. Another rhino guy. So anyway, I just wanted to leave you with the facts. And the fact is, there are dark energies in the world, whether they're demons or just kind of a presence that brings you down, it's the same kind of output. It's there to get you in a negative mind space. It's there to get you to yield to being negative and dark and sinister. And you don't have to do that. You know, you have to choose your philosophy. You have to choose how you think of yourself. Okay? That demon went in there. I got seduced. It was an interesting experience. I'll just leave it at that. But I didn't know it was a demon. I actually thought it was my emotional state. So I was tricked to the point where I thought its negative emotions were mine. And I was reacting to its negative shit. Just like Amy says from Physical and Spiritual is her channel. Physical and Spiritual. You know, it's not my shit, but I believed it was my shit. I believed it was mine, and I acted on it, and that was foolish. They're doing anything they can to stop anybody who believes in anything that's good to do anything. And they already got me. I'm 52. I got nothing. I'm up the creek, you know. I'm going to keep trying some other shit to do on the side, but, you know, I'm not a good hustler. I didn't set myself up to be a hustler. I set myself up to be an employee. And I'm an employee. And employees get paid shit. I'm just a slave. So you know, that's just an example. I'm not crying or anything. I'm just giving that to you as an example so that you understand that they are serious about ruining the planet and making it ripe, like you would ripen an orange or an apple by leaving it outside for a while, not putting it in the fridge. You know, you ripen it so that at the right time you eat it and it's at its peak. Okay? When they're getting us socioeconomically to the point where we're going to be at our peak. You're going to see demon possession out in the street. You're going to see people looting, causing fires. You're going to see cities burn. You're going to see so much disorder that people are going to go crazy and not know what to do. Now, JSX is another person I follow. He recently basically said he's passing away. He said that it would take maybe, I think it was 3 or 6 months or so for him to clean up the garbage on the other side, because he's laid claim to a lot of power and a lot of position, to be frank. A whole lot more than I thought would be possible. So that's what he's doing. And I think that he might pull it off or he might not. Either way, I just want people to be prepared for the thought processes involved. Dark, sinister, negative emotional states. People reacting badly because they can't operate like this. They can't operate. And they're in a state of survival where they're trying to climb above and get out of the water and not drown. This is happening at a worldwide level. It is not happening just in the United States. It's everywhere. Every country, every area is going to get it. America was like the philosophical, it was like Atlas, okay? America held the world up above his shoulders, right? It was like Atlas. The entire weight of the world was on America's shoulders, and Atlas is starting to crumble, okay? Because Atlas just can't do it anymore. America can't do it anymore. And you're going to see security vulnerabilities in this nation. You're going to see foreign governments making a play for this nation. You're going to see all kinds of shit. And most of these people, they're going to operate socioeconomically. They're going to try to buy this place out. They're going to try to sell it out cheap. All kinds of... Now, I've heard about all these dark magicians and how they do things. And I got to tell you, in the end, you are always fucked. And they are always walking out with all the money, walking out with all the value. And it's just sad. They make no sense because that's their nature. Their nature is to be assholes, and that's what they do. But anyway, I just thought I'd put my opinion out there. This is just my opinion. Please don't get offended. Don't tell me this or that. I mean, if you don't believe me, do your own research. I see a historical parallel between Nazi Germany and what's going on now at a world level. I see this place being ripened up to be a good climate for an Antichrist. We always say that in the old days, like last 20 years, they would say, oh, Trump is the Antichrist, or what's his name? Joe Biden, the guy before them, Bush. The bushes are, stay out of the bushes, they're the Antichrist. I mean, ladies and gentlemen, if you get an Antichrist, the whole world will bend the knee to him. It won't be a president. It'll be they'll basically call him God. If that scenario and the scripting in the Bible, and that's really what it is, it's just a script. But if that comes to pass, it's going to be somebody that you will overwhelmingly be willing to give your sons and daughters to, so they can go out and fight righteous wars, just like the extremists. So, I mean, that's what the potential that's in the world. Now, I'm hoping that Jay is not crazy and that Jay takes care of business. And I really do. I love the guy, but I don't know what the truth is anymore. I know that his power was real, but it was very light, delicate, like you're doing surgery. It's not something like, you know. It wasn't anything forceful. And I think to take care of a lot of creatures over there, you're going to need a lot of forceful power, you know. So I'm hoping for the best, just like everybody else. But I see that people are becoming desperate. Dude, you would never want to live in your fucking car. Never. It's a fucking chore. I did it for a week. I'm telling you, it was 3 to 4 times the work to live in a regular home, because you're always swapping out water. You don't have enough room. You're minimizing. You're living out of a storage unit, basically sleeping in the car. You're vulnerable to weather. So if it's too cold, you're freezing your ass off. If it's too hot, you're burning up in the middle of the night. Right now, it's like probably 11 o'clock at night. No, it's 10 o'clock at night, and it's still fucking hot out there. It's hot. At 10 o'clock at night, ladies and gentlemen, how are you going to sleep in your car at 10 o'clock at night that fucking hot, man? I had to go out and buy, I had to get water. I had to get ice, because without ice, man, I would fry. I had no choice. I had to go to a gas station. Every time they said that when you had the ankle bracelet on, it came to a point where I didn't have to ask permission for going to get gas. I could go get gas on the way, like I'm transporting between work and home. I could stop by and get gas, and that's what I did. I'd stop by, get gas, and I would get ice and put in my cooler. And that's how I survived the heat at night. You know, I had a Jackery, I think it's Jackery 2000, and I had three of those little USB fans going at one time. Three of them. And the Jackery would last about almost 2 days before I had to charge it up again. You know, and it took forever to charge that thing. It's not a quick charge. I have the older model, and it takes forever. And that's the only way I could survive. I would like spray water on myself. You know how you sprinkle yourself with water and you let the air hit you? That's how I did it. It's really hard. I was living in an SUV. It sucked. My cats were homeless. They were outside waiting for me to feed them. I'd go out into the street and I'd call them to me, and I'd feed them there, and I'd hope nothing happened to them. Thankfully, nothing happened to the cats over there where I used to live. And I managed to transport them to the new place. As you know, recently I lost my gray cat. I don't know where he is. He's MIA. And I've lost other cats for other reasons. But, you know, I've done what I can. That cat was over there homeless. I took him in. I fed him for at least two and a half years. And I love that cat. He's like my little brother. And he's gone. MIA. You know, if I ever see him again, it would be a miracle. But I can tell you, if he was in the area, he'd be over here eating. He would be home. You go out there and make a bunch of racket, and I know he's there. But I haven't heard him since. It's just one of those things, you know. And I want you to understand that all this is a script. It's a play. And they're playing their parts. And they don't care about right or wrong. I am compromised. I am contaminated. I am vulnerable, and I'm in a position where I'm able to see this trend, and I see it in people. I see things going through people, and it's no good. It's people pretending everything is okay, and they're becoming desperate. They're becoming the desperado, the desperate man, and desperate people are the most dangerous people. The elitists and the government, they're desperate to maintain power and control. But people are desperate to survive, right? And they will do a lot of things. Right now, you guys are getting a good taste of how it's going to be, and it's going to get worse. So be prepared for that mentally. Try to hold your peace, keep your peace. Don't justify anybody to put you in a jail, because once you go into that jail, whether you did a crime or not, the system doesn't care. You're in a box, and then eventually they'll put you in general population. Then you're really going to have some fun, okay? Because they're still isolating people for the COVID. Last time I checked, you know, just be prepared, you know. And Amy from Spirit and Physical and Spirit, no, Spiritual and Physical, or Spirit and Physical, she keeps crying out to benevolent beings. She keeps crying out to whoever listens. And she says there's only like 5 benevolent beings out of the 400 that are subscribed. So supposedly all these demon people and perps are subscribing to her channel, right? And I'm like, well, last time I checked, you know, I can't do it anymore. My soul's fucking, I'm really fucked up. I'm really far gone. I'm pretty much over the hill, through the woods, and gone with the wind, pretty much. But there used to be a lot of benevolent people out there. But, you know, they got eaten away because over time, people got programmed to be more and more corrupt, more and more evil, more and more negative. And eventually, they just kaput, started becoming a rare species. I can only remember a few benevolent people, and each and every one of them had no power. They had nothing but a pocket full of good intentions that added up to nothing. They didn't have any power to change the world. Okay? And that's what I'm saying. You know, like this character here, she's got skill. She's got a sword. She's got a cool backpack for free. I got that free with the joining. This is a different server. It's a very heavily modded server. But this character is designed to excel, go up in levels, achieve goals, and eventually become a very high-level player. Most people wouldn't even be able to pick up that fucking sword, much less use it. You know, they just wouldn't be able to do that. They wouldn't be able to put on the armor and go out and kill a bunch of shit. That's too much to ask. Most regular people are psychologically unprepared for what's going on. And it's not right. I think it's unfair. I think it's cruel that man is being put in this vulnerable situation. Okay. So anyway, the point is that be prepared in any way that you can, psychologically, physiologically, or whatever, spiritually, for what'll happen. We're going to lose some people. We're going to suffer. There's no real we anymore. There's no real us. There's no real union. It's just a bunch of individuals trying to put up with each other and with the powers that be to try to survive another day. It's there's not a lot out there. Most people are flaky, useless, crazy, stupid as hell. I mean, I do customer service. I'm telling you, there's some stupid fuckers out there calling the bank without their account number. They don't know their social. They don't have any identifying information, and I'm supposed to bring them up and give them secure information over the phone. I mean, it's stupid shit like that. I mean, no common sense kind of people. And don't be that way, you know. And if you are, I understand. What can you do? But try, you know. I wish you all the best. I didn't mean to drag this on for a whole hour, but I want you to understand that I do care, but I've learned that there's things I have no control over. Once that system, that jail system gets you, you're over. They will take your car. They'll take your home. They'll take your cat. They don't give a shit. They will take all the money in your bank account and call it civilized. Call it reasonable. Say that you have constitutional rights, which there was no constitutional rights in Bexar County Jail. There was no rights anywhere. You have the right to shut the hell up or do what I say and I won't tase you, beat you up, or spray that shit in your eyes. Okay? That was my choice. Okay? I didn't really have any other real choices. I'm sorry. It's true. Oh, it looks like this guy got stuck in there. Got him. Okay, so he warped out of there. Anyway, thanks for listening. Thanks for watching, I guess. You know, it's not a gaming video, really. I just so happen to be playing. And thank you for thinking about it. I want you to think about this shit that I've said. It's like they're rats on a ship and they're starting to come out of the bowels of the ship and going onto the deck of the ship, trying to survive with living in a van. And, oh, I got this TikTok thing and it makes me so much money a month. Oh, I got another side hustle over here. They're trying to survive and adapt, and they're not facing the reality of the situations. And that is that the corporations have pretty much run everything into the ground and have ruined the economy. A bunch of evil, greedy people in charge have ruined everything in this country. I can't retire. There's no such thing. It doesn't exist. I can claim retirement, but I'll still be working. I might even be living out of my fucking van, or not my van, my SUV. And there's no room in there. It's a small SUV. So, you know, guys, and what am I going to do with my cats? You know, the only thing I could think of is leave them here, set them free outside, and come at night and feed them. Try to feed them as long as they're in the area, because they will stick together as much as they can, and just give them all the food that I can. I can park here because nobody checks the licenses. Nobody checks it here, so I can park here and be close to them, but that's all I could do. If I lose this apartment, if I lose this job, it's a horrible situation. I got no backup. My father left me when I was 2. My mother abused the fuck out of me, and I felt like I was like basically demon harassed my entire life. Even the Lord on the side, even the Lord confessed what was going on, that stuff was going on. And I won't go into it, but I'll tell you, when the Most High confesses something, that tells you, yeah, he knows. But he didn't change anything. The Most High God confirmed the situation. He verified it, but he didn't change anything. Not to the degree it needs to be changed. He kept letting it go and letting it go. And you know what? I have to let everything go too, because I can't afford to help anybody. I had a guy living here, and he was a friend of mine, but he was a bum. And you know what? The sad thing is, I had a feeling that this guy wasn't going to pay me. He paid me a couple of times, and then that was it. All of a sudden, he's too sick. He can't do anything. He can't find a job, blah, blah, blah. He wanted me to wait another month and a half for him to find a job and get paid. He wouldn't have gotten paid for at least 2 months. And I go, I can't have you here. You know, I can't carry you. I told him. And so I had to let him go. As cruel as that is, I had to let him go. Thankfully, he kept his job. He did manage to get a job, keep his job, and he seems to be doing okay. But I wouldn't be surprised if he's living downtown again. But at least he's working, you know. If he's working full-time, he's saving that money. You know what I mean? So he's getting somewhere. He's doing something. So that I did save somebody, basically. And I'm thankful for that I got to participate like that. But I can't do that shit again. You know what I mean? So side hustle, here I come. I have nothing stopping me from getting that money. I have nothing stopping me from doing whatever it takes to get paid. And that's the bottom line now. Money. You know, if I go up to the apartment manager over here in the complex and I say, hey, I can only pay you $800 out of the $1,200. Is that okay? He's going to say, no, it's not okay. We'll start the eviction notice because you didn't pay rent. That's what he'll say. That's reality, folks. This guy, you know, he comes and he's a nice guy. I love the guy, but he's like, oh, I can only pay this much. It's like, okay. So I took it, but, you know, I don't get the option to just say I can only pay this much. You know what I mean? So, you know, you got to find people. If you do rent out a room like I tried to do and do stuff like that, please be careful of what you're doing. It is not the same. People, even nice people like my friend, tend to be critical. They don't like to be told what to do. And they will take food from you. They'll take toiletries, you know, stuff like that. I offered it to him because I knew he was in need and I wasn't going to do anything. You know, I wasn't going to charge you for TP and shit like that. But, you know, because I'm in the situation, I can't carry him. I can't be giving you free electricity, free TP, free soap, and all this shit, and you not compensate me somehow. So I asked him, and this I'll go into it a little bit more real quick. I asked him to do some work for me, you know, help me take out the cat poo, you know, the cat poo litter box, clean up, sweep, and stuff like that. But, you know, I didn't really need a maid. I could do that myself. What I needed was I needed money. I need cash. I need money. I don't need bullshit. Bullshit doesn't pay my rent, you know, unless it maybe is on YouTube. But anyway, I put this video out there just to let you know I see the trend. You know what happened. You could do your own historical research to see what happened back then. Grandma said he just went crazy one day and you know, that was it. Yeah, Hitler thought he was, you know, God on earth. He was a type of an Antichrist. That's what he was. And he started out as a good, virtuous person. And based on my experience with demonic possession, I can tell you that man, if he was a regular person, he wasn't a saint, because I went through a process to be sainted. I went through a process to be one of the Most High God's children through faith and consecration and swaying in the Holy Spirit. The whole thing. I did that for decades. Okay? And that gave me a lot of protection. Not anymore, but, you know, it did. And over there in the old days, you know, it was, I had resistance. Nowadays, I don't. So if that guy, Hitler, was a regular person that just prayed little prayers and he was never consecrated, he was never, you know, pretty much slain in spirit, you know, to the point where you get so much of the Holy Spirit, your bones start to burn with fire, just like the old prophets. That's what happened to me. That's your consecration. That's your purification, purified in the fire of the Holy Spirit. Well, the thing is, if he didn't go through something extreme like that, he wouldn't have any protection, and he'd be pretty damn vulnerable, wouldn't he? So it's understandable that whatever fool is put up there as the Antichrist, it's probably just going to be a husk ready to be possessed. And it's going to be vulnerable or something somehow. You know, I mean, I've experienced it. And it'll subtly go up and it'll be like a seducing spirit. If you look in the scriptures in the King James Version, it talks about seducing spirits. And once you listen to these spirits, they'll tell you whatever the hell you need to hear. They'll put you down. They'll play with you at an emotional level. It's horrible what happens. And in the end, you just don't want anything to do with that. Don't need anything to do with that. You let that shit in, you're gone. And so, like I said, what I have to focus on for myself, just to give you a little FYI, is my diabetes, my physical body, my psychological frame, and my spiritual frame, my framework, you know. And I have exercises I do. I have things that I try to accomplish to stay in a positive frame of mind. And I want you guys to stay in a positive frame of mind. You can curse out, you can chew out, you can get pissed off and all that. But when you're done exploding, come back to a more benevolent outfit. And learn from the experience and grow from the experience. And that is the best you can do. You're not going to conquer the world, but you can sure as hell hold your peace in the middle of the storm. You can sure as hell try to remain as positive as possible. You know, I have plans for these beings that did this to us. If I do survive and I get over there, I'm gonna be taking care of business too. Jay's not the only one that's pissed off. Jay just is claiming to have a bigger hammer. That's all. But he's pissed off too. And that's why he's going to, quote unquote, clean this shit up. And I'd be happy to grab a mop and help him if that's what it takes. I have other plans for these fuckers too, but that's a different story, and I won't be telling that story. Yeah. Anyway, it's an hour and 25 minutes. Sorry for the length of the video. I've been watching this shit so long online, listening to Jack Morgan and all these other people, and listening to Amy, and listening to Spirit and Physical. Been listening to JSX. I've been listening to the 13th Son. That's another one to look up. The 13th Son, D-A-13-T-H-S-U-N, 13th Son. I mean, he went over, because Amy brought up a topic saying that she wanted to know how to escape the system through portals and all this shit. Well, they built military bases on the fucking portals. So unless you can get past the military base, or you can astral your ass out of here, you're stuck. The other alternative, if not a portal, is you have to become your own portal and Merkaba out of here. You become your own portal to another dimension, and you step within yourself. You step out of this place by going into yourself, and then you disappear and go into another place. I personally, I don't tinker with that shit, so I don't expect to do it. That's not my style. I normally pick up the sword and start slashing, but even that is not going to happen. So I don't really have an option. I'm going to stay here, take care of my cats. I'm 52, so I maybe have anywhere from 0 to 20, 30 years left. Those 20 and 30 years are going to go real fast. You know, I'm not trying to accomplish anything down here anymore. Not in this planet. Not the way things are. My life, I've been attacked my entire life. You know, people just don't believe me, and that's fine. But I'll tell you something. Sometimes people tell the truth. Sometimes they don't want to sell you something. Sometimes they just want to prepare you or drop the knowledge so that you have a chance. That's all. And anyway, with that, I'll let you go because it's pretty late. Thank you for watching. Sorry for the length of the video. I'm going to mark this one special. This is not going inside my video game thing. I'm going to put this separate, probably under True Soul. And just thanks for watching. Thanks for listening. Just some things to consider. That's all I can say. Bye-bye.